What is up, guys and gals? Welcome back. We're going into the administrator's office in Wasted. Welcome on back. Happy to have you here today. Our plan is just to go as deep down into the dungeon as we can. I'm a little bit bummed out that we didn't take that pupae thing, but it's too late now. Oh shit, that's not good.
Citadel, this is Purifier Charlie. Completed a full sweep of the administrator's offices. Our engineers have checked the cooler mainframes and have confirmed that the Serpent Protocol has not yet been activated and that the escape pods are in full working order. Prepare the cure carrier for deployment as we make our push towards the cryo chambers. Victory is at hand. We will make these wasters pay for what they did to Star. Charlie, out.
He conveniently didn't turn around and see us. Hooray! No, I love not being seen. I would rather move stealthily like a ninja. What kind of stuff do we have in here? Kitchen knife, black headband, nothing really. I mean, some okay things. Nothing up under the stairs that they're trying to hide from me. Anything in the fridge? You got any liquid bread? I'll take all the liquid bread that you got. Liquid bread sounds great to me. I mean, it doesn't sound appetizing, but it heals so much that I'd feel stupid if I didn't bring it with me. Alright, so we gotta turn the elevator back on. I don't see anything else inside of here. Oh, he already turned the elevator on. What about, can I turn off the robots? Like, is that an option? Oh man, apparently I can't. So I guess I can just go down whenever I want to. Let me check the terminal real fast. Those crazy commie sons of bitches did it. They actually did it. At approximately 300 hours, a nuclear strike was made against Little Rock Air Force Base. Though we were unable to establish communications with the base, the method and nature of the attack are so undeniably sleazy that it could only have been perpetrated by our good friend Brezhnev and his pack of greaseball commie lapdogs. Needless to say, our retaliation was quick and it was fierce, and by golly, it was loud as hell. As American as apple pie. All of the top brass are ushered into this cool air evacuation colony. Apparently these things were built in the 50s, but goddamn the technology in here is a goddamn testament to good old-fashioned American ingenuity. San Diego is still being bombarded above ground. Thank God for the cool air shelter, that we might rise from the ashes to kill whatever's left of those commie scumbags. What did this to our goddamn fine country? The weaponry we've got locked up in here, I'm told, is quite experimental, but I've been assured that it will give us a marked tactical advantage in the new world. Militroids, they're called. Now, color me a skeptic. It'll be the day when a bucket of bullets can outmaneuver and outfight a goddamn red-blooded American soldier. Those boys at Alistair Research Labs have put together a fine killing machine. Fine enough to kill a commie dog, anyways. Apparently, these militroids have become activated, or will become activated, once we've awoken from cryogenic sleep and will defend the shelter from any aggressors while our men regain their bearings. Just received word that a communique was sent out from Little Rock shortly before the nuclear blast. Apparently, the nuclear blast that started this whole thing was caused by a goddamn Air Force grease monkey accidentally dropping a socket on a goddamn Titan II, and not the goddamn commie bastards after all. The USSR was caught completely off guard by our so-called retaliatory strike, and from what I've heard has been reduced to ashes. Meanwhile, the rest of the world has responded to our unprovoked nuclear attack on the USSR with strikes of their own. It's the goddamn apocalypse up there. Good lord, what have we done? I don't think it's a we thing. I think it's more of like, who dropped the socket wrench? Granted, the Cold War was a terrible idea from the top to the bottom. Oh, he's got TP in here, though. Got TP in here, though. Nothing in the shower. Somebody had said something about there being a box up underneath the stairs or something like that, but I don't see it. It is not safe to sleep now. Well, fine then. I don't want to take a nap anyways. We don't really have very much ammo. This could be kind of a rough day for me. This could kind of be a really, really rough day for me if this doesn't go a little bit better than it has been. Alright, the bees used to be called the Bella Scouts before the apocalypse. We haven't seen any of them yet. I assume they're in a later cooler. Oh no. So much ammo. God, those things are so nasty. They're so grumpy all the time. They soak up all my bullets. Every single one of my bullets, they're like soak, 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 soak. Soak, straight to the face. You got nothing. Well, he's got buckshot, I guess. I made this with real blood. None of that imitation shit. Die! You damn dirty robots. Rifle ammo. We got another greaser in here. This is not turning out so well. This is going quite poorly. If I do say so myself. Unmarked flask. Why not? Let's do it. It's got a sunshine next to it. A smiling sunshine. What's the worst that could happen? Yay! We're better at oblitting. I don't know exactly what oblitting is, but we've apparently gotten better at it. I want no part of this gunfight. This gunfight is not looking like the sort of thing I want to be involved in. Guns ain't doing it no mo. And that's mostly because they nerfed our shoot stat. So when we lost all of our shoot stat, unfortunately, we are going to have trouble dealing damage now, which we weren't having trouble with earlier. Alright, don't really need the junk food right now. Ooh, there's our exit right there, so never mind. Might be worth it to take a little bit more of a look around. Just because we found the exit so quickly. See if maybe we could pick up a bit more ammo. Love it if you could do me a favor and die in a spot that's not in the way of all the loot. There's a flask. An ammo box, which I will happily take. Man, we ain't fighting nobody right now, are we? Jesus. Bleary-eyed is what killed us here. If we end up having a lot of trouble, bleary-eyed is what's gonna be the one that makes this way more difficult than it needs to be. Gonna wait for him to come closer. There we go. Doesn't strike me as the kind of weapon you're supposed to be using at long ranges. Seems like it excels at being very, very close to the enemy. Phaseroid, how you doing? Some ammo. It's gonna have to hold. We don't have a choice. I don't think he knows we're here. Works for me. No complaints from my side of the field. God, ain't nothing dropping ammo right now. Oh, really? That's an SOB right there. Okay. Well then. I thought there was something on the floor back there. Cool. That'll save some bullets. And nothing else in there, unfortunately. I was hoping maybe they'd have something good for me, but nope. It's a fun. Ow. That was unfriendly. All I wanted to do was hang out for a little while. She needs so many stereos for, man. Seems like a bit much. buckshot. Some rifle ammo, which really doesn't make me feel that much better. I used to be able to hide behind my Kalashnikov, and now I can't hide behind it anymore. It does the best it can, but it's just not putting down the ye old shooties that we need. I think that's going okay. I don't know, it's kind of hard to appraise exactly how this run is going because I've been so low on ammo the entire time that... Oh, I've got chick-chick ammo. It's not going to help us versus robots, but it'll help versus some of these guys. Ran out of bullets at the wrong moment. Luckily, he can't really hurt us either. I mean, he can try, but it's not really doing much. The things that are really, really bad in here are the robots, though. The robots are like, holy shit bad. That robot seems to want to fight me in fisticuffs, but I am neither a gentleman nor a man who will be fooled into such endeavors. Instead, I choose to fight you in the old-fashioned American way of gunslinging. I don't think we're going to find anything over there, so let's keep going this way. Oh, actually, this looks like a dead end too. Let's go ahead and leave them to deal with each other. They seem like the kind of guys that deserve one another. Tripping hazard. Shit. Couldn't decide which gun I wanted to use to finish the job. A lot of workbenches around here. I assume there must be work being done then, thus to facilitate a bench dedicated for work. We're finding the exits pretty quickly on these ones. I'm actually kind of surprised. Normally these deeper down dungeons take a lot longer to work your way through. God, the knockback. Luckily, it works on them too. Oh my God. It's hard to do anything here without unloading on people. Didn't really know which way he was going to come around from. He's got a Tommy gun and a vault clearer. I'm going to take the vault clearer because we need bullets of some kind. More poop and pills. Oop, I'm sorry. Give me that shit back. We got problems. Real, legitimate problems. Give me the vault clearer. And we're just going to have to make this work for now, I guess. Unless this thing's got power packs on it, which it does. It's got a couple. That's not going to be enough, but... Okay, there's another one down. 11 power packs to be had. Only goal for right now is to help the robots out. and then betray them. Like the filthy, rotten human I am. Is everybody down? Okay, everybody's dead. Got a buckshot over there. I knew somebody was firing a shotgun in here. There's a little bit more ammo. I'm kind of tempted to take the Emma, because it'll force me to pick my shots a little better. Yeah. Anything that forces me to be better at my job and do like one-shot kills or whatever is probably a smart plan. I mean, with my shoot so low, I'm not killing anything anyway, so it's kind of rough. Doesn't look like a Tommy gun. Then again, it's got a stick mag. And I think traditionally most people seem to identify the Tommy gun with a drum mag. Rifle ammo, power packs, okay. Gotta give me something to play the game with here. Trying to pistol me to death right now, man? I do not accept this. I want you to know I am offended. Take that Emma. I'll take those power packs. Life will be good. Kalash is looking a little bit better. Missed the door. Ow. There we go. We'll juggle her down. She's got rifle ammo, as does she, as far as I know. Almost out of ammo for the chick chick. We really shouldn't be back here right now. This is a bad mistake. We run a real chance of getting isolated by the SOB back here. Yeah, exactly. Let's head back. I don't want to take any chances. Klaznikova's reloaded, though, so that's a plus. Hey, there's some buckshot. Don't mind if I do. I was gonna say, making it through a room without somebody trying to murder me seems really unlikely. I don't think that's ever happened before in this game. Phaseroid. What is happening? 10 power packs. I'm kind of concerned about the way the final boss fight is going to go. Oh my god, metastooms. Okay. Ain't no more ammo down in here. Oh, there's the creepy mask right there. That's one of our craftable items. I'll probably take that with me. Now, we just gotta hope we don't get trapped in a hallway anywhere. That's a rocket? Look at the size of that thing. Good lord. What do you need a rocket that size for? All the lockers are empty. Plant people porter, there it is again. There's more regeneration. Mama Margarita, killing enemies in rapid succession gets you 50 damage. Okay. Hit shot, that'll increase your hit by 1. And the Juke Julep, blocking attacks temporarily negates the blocking movement speed penalty. Oh, we're so close though. Like, part of me wants to push through to the end and just like see what we can accomplish. Because the cryo tanks are the last room, right? Oh man, I know we can do this. We just have so little ammo though. Oh, we're cutting it so close. I don't have any grenades or anything left either. Ah, we're gonna do it, whatever. I'm sure it'll be okay.
Crap, Citadel. Cooler 2 is compromised. I repeat, Cooler 2 is compromised.
Well, shit. I come in peace!
Big cojones to stand there after seeing me deal with the syndicate pig, Wister. Big cojones, or a big mistake.
A bit from column. Actually, I don't have any. That's true, I'm a female. I don't have any cojones.
Fortunately for you, the only big you'll be is a big mess. Be assured of that. The million peso question is, will it be the radiation that melts you down, or this big-ass tank? Personally, Wister, my money's on this big-ass tank.
How did you get a tank down here? Yeah, well, my money's on shut the hell up.
Big mouth, too. I like that. But I'd choose my words more carefully if I was you, Wister. Not many people come face to face with a coyote. At least, not many who survive talk about it.
Well, kind of hard to come face to face with a mass freak, ain't it?
Yes, the mask. You see, our ancestors told tales of selfish fire beings, stood high upon the mountaintops, orbiting the power of fire for themselves, for fear that man would learn its use and become as powerful as they. As the story goes, it was but a lowly coyote, underestimated and unnoticed, that was able to sneak into the fire being's camp, stealing the power of fire from their tight-fisted clutches, and sharing it with the helpless people below. For this transgression, the fire being seized the tip of the coyote's tail. But the people, they now control the power. To see, we master these people. We call ourselves coyotes as well. And your country, I'm sure the irony of this big smoking crater being the land of the fire beings is not lost on you, Mister. We coyote travel into the light scorched depths of the cold, where other men dare not tread. We take from it the weapons and supplies that your American military has ordered for itself and distribute them to our servicemen brothers so that our power and influence might reclaim this land. As for our masks, let's just say that the extreme radiation down here has not been so kind to the structure of the face.
Why do you have a napkin tucked into your sternum, bro? I don't see you wearing a shirt or anything. You need to put some proactive on those arm zits too, man. Those things are gnarly. Those things are really gnarly. It's not the only thing that's gonna be unkind to your face.
So hasty on today. Very well. We coyotes have never been ones to waste an opportunity for a good fight. Let us exchange blows, little waster, and we shall see who splatters first.
Yeah, I don't want to be anywhere near that shit. Ow. Please stop trying to gun me down. I don't much like it. I think we might have enough bullets to make this happen. Oh shit, there's bear traps everywhere now. Although they mostly seem to be along the walls. Ah, circle strafe for your life. Yeah, I think we could take him. Oh, bear traps everywhere. Now I just gotta hope that I don't step on any of this shit. I don't think there's that many bear traps around. Like, there's my blood right there. That or I dropped a can of spaghetti sauce, I don't know. Fuck. Come on. Oh yeah, I can't be stopped by bear traps. I forgot that we got that little, that thingy that makes it so we can't step on bear traps and die anymore. Is he dead? So he doesn't have to climb out of there or anything? Because I thought maybe he'd have to climb out of there or something. Fine then. I don't want to play anyways. Oh, he's over here. So he's got the coyote mask, which makes you better at fighting and you take less damage from radiation. He's got the murder mariachi shirt. I don't know. I'll take the slacks, and I guess the murder mariachi shirt. Yikes, you are not pretty. You weren't kidding, but you are swole. So, you know, way to work towards your strengths. That's cool. Now we gotta do the serpent protocol or whatever. Alright, let's see what bonuses we got now. We already know how to do that. So we've got the Furt and Fort bag kit. Oh, hold on. Let me turn on the serpent protocol first. Initiate. You know, you think for all the money they spent on these vaults, they could have gotten signs that weren't written in crayon. I don't know. What does this do? Adds a garden where you can grow vegetables. Let me know when we got a garden that can grow cheeseburgers. Adds a robotics lab to your house that can allow you to build a robot companion that can fight alongside you. Hell yeah. Adds a shooting range to your player home that allows you to set a target faction to gain a damage bonus against. Oh, that's pretty good too. Well, I need to have my own R2-D2, so we're gonna go with a pet robot. Yes, give me the pet robot. It jumped out at me the most. My companion-droid. It's weird that there was graffiti in that room considering nobody's supposed to have been in there yet. Maybe the administrator was just passive aggressive.
Yellow car. Just like our informant said, you took down the SOB in this cooler too?
Yeah, sorta.
Wow. Then it really is you. The new skeleton army's been keeping tabs on you, Waster.
The new skeleton army?
Yeah, you probably heard us in that radio broadcast we get out here. We're a group of freedom fighters, dedicated to keeping the booze flowing and the good times rolling. See, The head Skelly said those SOB bastards have got something big planned. Something that could put an end to our way of life. You know, getting loaded and shot at a whole bunch. The good life.
Who's the head Skelly?
Well, not very many people have talked to the head Skelly himself. Truth is, the new skeleton army is a real loose network of wasters. Chances are you've talked to a few of us already without even realizing it. I probably have too, but with the booze I'm downing, I hardly recognize anything these days. Head Skelly says the anonymity saves our organization from the loose lips our reckless lifestyle tends to breed. Speaking of, the only way of identifying one another is by our secret password. Beef, booze, and bruises.
Beef, booze, and bruises.
Hell yeah. The three B's. All you need in life. Look, pal, word on the wire is that the head Skelly is real impressed with the work you've been doing. Now, I don't know much about the man himself, but the kind of people he's got working for him, I'm sure he could give you a real primo life in the waste if you play your cards right. We got a couple of us stationed at the Oni. Come on by. We might have some work for you to do.
Cool.
All right, good luck, Waster. And remember, beef, booze, and bruises.
All right, guys. We are out of time for the day. My name is Splattercat. We just beat Cooler Number 2. I will see you on the next episode. Hi-do.